Well, the city of Memphis is no stranger to breaking records, so the fact that the Bluff City set a new record with more than 11 million visitors last year should not come as a surprise.
Love that good news. What does it mean for those of us who already live, work, and play here and know what a great city it is? Well, President and CEO of Memphis Tourism, Kevin Kane, is so happy to spread that news worldwide.
Absolutely.
He's here now.
But what, because we've always had a number of really big tourist attractions. Graceland, for instance, I think it's still the third largest visit.
Well, it is the largest private resident visit in the United States.
Right, because we're talking about White House beating that.
Oh, yeah, the White House has.
What is it that has increased the numbers so exponentially over the last year?
You know, this is a global destination, you know, because of our legacy, especially our music legacy. People literally come here from all over the world. That's why we have representation in the UK, in Germany, now in Australia. We have a full-time employee in Australia.
Really?
Australia is our third busiest international market after Canada and the United Kingdom.
If that job
we never
up.
Knew that for sure.
You guys
remember your girl.
Yeah. So, Kevin, with those numbers in mind, though, who's coming here now? Are we seeing more millennials? Are we seeing
Absolutely.
Older folks? Who's coming to Memphis, Tennessee?
We touch every market. That's the beautiful thing. Families, because we have great family offerings with the zoo and the children's museum and so many things for families to do. Singles, millennials, of course, you know, we've been voted many times, many publications, as one of the best places for millennials to relocate to because we're a great place to work, live, and play. Well, emphasis for me is on the play part because that's what attracts the visitors here. So.
Right.
And of course, with you know, even with baby boomers, Memphis is still a very popular destination. So, you know, we're touching all market segments. Our surge markets are the millennial markets. You're seeing a younger visitor come to our destination, and that's great for us because that's our future.
Well, and it's clearly affordable, but there's also Memphis doesn't hide from its story, and some of its story is not that pretty. It's got a We do have grit. We don't try to clean it up.
I mean, look at the National Civil Rights Museum.
Yeah.
I mean, let's face it, it was a tragedy. It was a dark moment in our history.
Very.
But now, when you go to the National Civil Rights Museum and you experience everything that offers there, it really is shows that Memphis was a turning point, and we rose above that.
Right.
You know, unfortunately, what happened is a tragedy.
Right.
We rose above that, and it's a great story now about equal rights and human rights and justice
Work
for all.
And of course, as more people come here to hear the stories of Memphis, Tennessee, Kevin, over the years, as you well know, one issue for those of us who live here, or especially those in your industry, has been hotel space. Where do we stand right there? More hotels coming to downtown Memphis or the city of Memphis?
We are having
to accommodate
a hotel
more
boom like we've never seen probably in decades, if ever, in our city. We have over 2,000 rooms that are under development right now in downtown Memphis. You know, there's over $1 billion being invested in tourism and hospitality right now, and there's hotels popping up literally from one end of downtown to the other. And of course, the pinnacle will be the 550-room Lowe's that we so desperately need, another big full-service hotel that will come
online. And for those who don't know,
years.
Kevin, what does that potentially position us for in the city of Memphis? We saw the success of what happened with the NFL, going to Nashville with their big presentation during, you know, the draft and all, attracting, you know, hundreds of thousands of folks over there. Can we position ourselves here in Memphis for big things like with the NBA All-Star Games if we have more hotel space?
NBA All-Star Games is a little different because they require 5,000 rooms and 12 hotels or less.
Okay.
I don't think we're going to get, there's about a third of the cities in the NBA that will probably never qualify for that, unfortunately.
But, we just may not have physical space.
Right, well, large hotels. We're talking about it. You need a lot of large hotels.
Right.
But in most NBA cities, as I said, over a third of the cities don't have that. But we're positioned for greatness because we are transforming our existing hotel product with beautiful, new, upgraded boutique hotels.
Mm-hmm.
Even some of our existing properties, like the Madison, is now the Hue.
Yes.
And, you know, the old Howard Johnson's is now a beautiful Hotel Indigo. I mean, they gutted that facility out and built it back up.
Mm-hmm.
The Benchmark right across from AutoZone Park is going to be a Canopy by Hilton, a very upscale, trendy, cool concept. The DoubleTree is going to close and go through a total renovation. It's going to come back as Hotel Tennessee.
Oh, cool.
A very cool, trendy hotel. And, of course, you got the brand-new Hilton Garden Inn. You got the Carlisle Project.
So you have those hotels, but what about convention space itself? What are the plans there
convention
for the renovation
space,
of the convention center?
The $200 million renovation of the convention center is going to add more breakout meeting rooms, which we desperately need, more flexibility in the facility.
And we're looking at some images
right
there.
Looking at the renderings right there. It's transformative. What the city and what we're doing to that convention center. And let me also, I always have to remind our viewers that no general fund property tax money is going towards this project. It is 100% being paid for by Tourism Development Zone, which is basically tax money that would otherwise go back to Nashville.
Right.
And hotel motel bed taxes at the visitors.
I have to ask you, bring up Nashville because their growth has bothered many of us, but their growth has come with infrastructure. Their infrastructure is not kept up. Are we doing enough with our infrastructure to keep up so that we don't have
that problem? That we are. We're kind of right-sizing our product right now. That's and some of that is additional growth. I think we have, stronger capacity in the downtown core than a lot of people realize.
Okay.
And your next guest can talk about that. And we're just really excited about where we are right now. We are basically transforming our city. We're not wiping the landscape clean. We're doing adaptive reuse, crosstown concourse.
That's where millennials too.
And the millennials love that.
You're right.
The Edge District. Look how cool that's going to be.
Yeah.
Gotcha. Kevin
Thank
Kane.
Thank you so much.
Memphis Tourism. Thank you very much. Appreciate you being here.